From the tip of Queensland's Cape York to Bundaberg, thousands of visitors to the Great Barrier Reef Marine Park regularly wet a line to catch a fish. The marine park is divided into a series of colour-coded zones, where different activities can and cannot occur. While green zones, or marine national park zones, are off-limits to fishing, the expansion of these areas a decade ago is proving to be a boon. Research shows green zones produce bigger fish and more of them.
Bigger fish produce more eggs, and more eggs basically means more baby fish out there in the water.
James Cook University scientists who are working with local fishermen on researching green zones on the Capricorn Coast have uncovered some impressive results.
And the statistics are actually quite staggering. For coral trout, 84% of the larvae produced in the Marine National Park Zone is being exported out to the zones you're allowed to fish in. And for the stripey, it's 54% of the offspring are being exported out of the Marine National Park Zone into the nearby fish zones.
If the green zones are left alone, then they produce fish for the other take zones. If you think about a green zone as being like a bank of fish, if there was a bank that was throwing money out the window and everyone was allowed to pick that up, why would you rob the bank?
All up, nearly 70% of the marine park is open to recreational fishing.
The zones in which you're allowed to fish are the light blue, dark blue, the yellow zones, and also the buffer zones, which allow trawling for pelagic species. You're not permitted to fish in the green zones, and you can't go and visit pink zones.
It's that balance between protecting the reef's biodiversity for the future and allowing for sustainable use that the zoning plan is all about. Such balance increases the Great Barrier Reef's resilience.
And if we want to think about maintaining these stocks for the future, for our children and for our grandchildren, and also to make sure that we've got spectacular places where divers can go and see some of the most amazing features, and places where recreational fishers can go and still catch a feed of fish for their families. If we take away the no-take areas, we are going to compromise all of those things.
If we leave that bank of fish alone, then they keep redepositing other fish into the areas where we can catch them, and your kids and grandkids.